Well, you join me today on the River Don at Conisbrough. It's an absolutely fantastic piece of water, and I'm here to give the response 8 metre system whip from Preston Innovations the workout. I'm going to show you how to approach this sort of venue and hopefully catch a few fish. Right, I'm going to talk to you a little bit now about this response system whip. It's 8 metres in length, and these last three sections, you can actually take them down to give you 7 metres, 6 metres, or 5 metres. It's totally up to you. Now, that gives you a lot of versatility, and you need that when you're going fishing, whip fishing in particular. Today, on the River Don, it's around about 10 or 11 foot deep at 8 metres, which is perfect for this sort of whip setup. It means I've got a little bit of line above the float to control the float nicely, but I can fish to hand. I'm not having to ship back and forth all the time. I'm not having to worry about the difficult banks or bikes or anything that are coming along. And it just makes my day really convenient. The nice thing about this whip is it's really slim. It's very strong, but it's slim, which means I can swing the rig out into position really easily. I've got perfect control of the float. I only need one hand. I just have the whip underneath my arm here, like I'd hold a rod, and it gives me plenty of stability for controlling that whip through the peg. It's a really nice one piece. Now, you'll notice while I'm fishing, I've got a flick tip in today. Personally, I really like a flick tip when I'm catching small fish like I am today. Small roach, odd bone, a skimmer. Personally, I really like that flick tip action. It allows me to strike into the fish with the guaranteed safety that I'm not going to bump it because it's too strengthy or too powerful. But then there's loads of forgiveness in here for them playing the fish. It also comes with a top kit that allows you to elasticate it. So if you're going over to Ireland where there's chances of these great big hybrids and things like that, you need a bit of elastic in there to cushion those bigger fish. And that gives you the option. So we've got two options there for you when you're setting up the whip. I've been fishing today at 8 metres because it's a nice depth, and you can tell I'm just getting into the flow here at 8 metres. And I've got some ground bait and maggots, and I'll run through these in a minute and tell you how I've gone about approaching the swim. Now, one thing I want to talk about when it comes to a whip is how you actually plumb up, because a lot of people ask me that. How do I plumb up a whip? It's quite difficult. I agree, it is difficult. It's not easy to get the depth really accurately correct. So you need a little bit of fishing skill here to help you out. And what I mean by that is the river's actually flowing, and it's got a nice steady flow downstream, which means if I can get the depth approximately right with a plummet, say within 6 inches or so, I can keep tweaking the float very slightly to get a nice clean run through the peg. You know, if you push the float up 2 or 3 inches, the float will drag under on the bottom. So if you inch it down an inch or two and it just holds through nice, you know you've found the perfect depth. And that's a little bit of watercraft there, and you need that with a whip because it's very difficult to plumb up as accurately as you do with a pole. So I've just attached my plummet on there. I'm gonna stand up to swing it out into the swim. And I just stand up and hold the line as tight as I can and allow the float to drop down. And you can see there where I've been fishing, it's absolutely dead depth. You can see the bristle just sticking out of the water with a plummet on the bottom. So I know, even though that line's at a bit of an angle, that I'm gonna probably have an inch or two of line on the bottom. And I started off with that, and I've just kept adjusting it throughout the day to get it nice, to get it running through the peg nice and smooth, with it, which is exactly what I'm doing at the moment. So with all that set up, with my rig all ready to go, I'm gonna run you through baits, I'm gonna run you through a little bit of my rig and my setup, and hopefully we'll catch a few fish. Let's have a look at the bait. Right, I'm just gonna run you through the bait that I'm using. Now, first of all, ground bait. Whenever I'm fishing a river or any sort of lake, when I'm fishing for roach and silverfish, ground bait's a really essential part of my mix, to be honest. And today I've just got a bag of Sonu Bait Black River and a bag of the natural coloured Lake. I've mixed those two together, and you can see here I've got a really nice dark brown consistency, which is the sort of colour I like to look for really when I'm fishing on venues such as this. Really nice colour without being overly light. This mix is mixed up quite damp, So when I can make a ball, it really does stick together nicely. You can see there, when it's stuck together, it's really well bound together. I don't want anything too dry, because this is quite a deep place here, and I'm gonna wanna be able to throw my balls to make sure they get to the bottom. If they were too dry, they just explode or break up too easily. So I've mixed about 2 kilos there, a bag of each. And I've got some live baits with me. Now, I've got some red maggots, which, to be honest, wouldn't go anywhere without maggots when I'm fishing for silverfish. Got a few pinkies in here, just as an alternative bait for the hook and probably feed. And of course, the mighty worm. All right, now worms are really, really good, especially for roach as well. People rule out worms for roach a lot of the time, but I really like them. I think they're a really key bait. Now, because I'm fishing with a whip, I haven't got the luxury of a pole cup or anything else, so I've got to be a little bit more old school, and I like to keep things dead simple. I think there's two real options of introducing my ground bait into the peg. The first is to throw small balls on a regular basis. So I could mix a little bit of bait in and just keep plopping a small ball in to see how it goes. And to be honest, this morning, that's how I started off. I had about an hour where I just made a little ball with one hand, small nugget, just like that. And I'd throw it in probably every couple of fish just to see if I could get a gauge to what was happening in the peg. Now, because there's so many fish in this river at the moment, the problem with that was a lot of bleak and smaller fish kept coming into the peg as well, and it made life difficult. I was swinging the rig out and getting hold-ups from nice bleak, to be honest, but they were being a bit confusing. So, to settle them down a bit, what I did was I took 3 big handfuls of ground bait and I put them into this excess bowl. So, just like that, 3 big double-handers, and then I took a pinch of each bait. Pinch of the maggots, pinch of the pinkies, and a pinch of the worms, but chopped up really fine. So I took these worms, chopped them up nice and fine, and put them in the ground bait as well. And what I did, I stirred it all around, so I had a really rich mix, which had maggots, pinkies, and worms in, and I made 3 really hard double-handed balls, okay, that were basically full of bait. So something like that, full of bait, odd maggot crawling out, doesn't matter. We're fishing a river, we want to try and get the fish down on the bottom, so I want that bit of activity. And then I balled them in right on the float, so I could then run the float over the top of the balls for probably half an hour to an hour with the fish a lot more settled on a bigger area of bait. And that has been working brilliantly, to be honest. I've caught 2 or 3 nice skimmers in that spell, some pommies and 2 or 3 nice roach, along with all the small roach and perch that I was catching anyway. So that's worked really well for me today. And it's a really simple bait bill. I brought 1.5 pints of maggots with me, 1/2 pint of pinkies and 1/2 kilo of worms. Job done for a lot of fish. Now, of course, I could loose feed as well. Could get my catapult out and loose feed the maggots into the peg. But this today, it's 10, 11 foot deep. There's a lot of bleak, there's a lot of small fish. So for me, loose feed hasn't been an option. But don't rule it out on your venue, because loose feed could help those fish that are looking around come down and really focus on your bait a little bit more. So don't rule out loose feeding on your venues as well. But that is a really nice setup to get you started. Right, let me run you through the rig that I'm using here. First of all, obviously, I've got an 8 meter whip. That doesn't mean 8 meters a line. I've actually made the line a little bit shorter than the whip, say about 1/2 meter. That allows me then to have the roach coming in at a nice level when I'm swinging them in, and I can swing them out. I don't want it too short, because then I'd be reaching for it. So when I haven't got a fish on, I need to swing it in at the right level. But I've set that up on 013 reflow power all the way through. Now you can see here, about 3 meters deep, 10 foot give or take, a bit more, probably about 10 foot I reckon. I've got a 3 gram alloy bolo float. Now the reason I've chosen a bolo float for this style of fishing is because I'm on a river, I've got my line behind the float and I need a little bit of control. So just having that shoulder on top of the float gives me a chance to put the float flue really nicely without it raising up. And you can see it's got a lovely hollow tip in there, so it's really visible. And I've got it set so just a small piece is showing, so I can read those bites and whack into it. And it's got a nice alloy stem to keep things nice and stable. A bit of silicone along the top, one underneath the body and one at the bottom of the float. So running down the rig, you can see here about 90 centimetres away from the hook, I've got an Olivet. And this Olivet is pinned by 3 number 8 shot above, and the Olivet itself is about 2.5 gram, and then I've got 10 number 8s below the Olivet. And those number 8s below act as like a boom. They stop the rig getting tangled. And having those 3 above and 10 below mean there's quite a big block of shot there, and it can't sort of twist over and tangle on itself. It's actually really difficult to get that tangled. Now, I'm not allowed bigger shot because in the UK, you can't use any lead shot over a size 8. And I didn't want to use the non-toxic stuff. So having a nice Olivet there takes the bulk of the weight, and then the number 8 spread nicely below. And as you move down a foot from the hook, I've got a double barrel swivel and a number 8. Now, the reason I use a swivel is because I'm in and out all the time with a whip. I'm picking the rig out of the depth, I'm laying it back in, and I don't want to get this thinner hook length spinning up. And having that swivel there allows the hook bait to spin without making the line twist. The spin comes out within the barrel of the swivel. So that's really handy. And then down at the bottom, on a foot hook length, I've got a size 18 N10 hook. Now, these new natural series hooks that we're doing at Preston Innovations, they're barbed hooks, and this is the N10 version. It's a really nice hook. It's got a long shank, it's very strong, but it's a light gauge of wire. The shape makes it quite strong, so when it's in, it is in. And I've caught some big fish today, some skimmers and big perch, and it's been no problem. So that's a nice size as well, an 18, allows me to put 1 or 2 maggots on and keeps it all simple. Like I said, everything's a nice length, so I can just pop a maggot on and then swing the rig out. And I want to swing the rig out, not straight in front of me, but slightly downstream. So I'll just swing it out there, slightly downstream, drag it back up into position. So everything's perfect, we're ready to go. Well, the fishing's been really interesting today. I've had a good run of fish, roach, perch, skimmers, bleak. It's been good, I've really enjoyed it. However, it's not been quite as easy as I had first hoped, because when we got here originally, it was absolutely solid. Enjoyed a really good period at the start, just for a few little balls in to start me off, just to see what was going on. And then once we felt the fish were all over the place, I ended up throwing 3 big balls in, like we talked about in the bait section. But after that, it wasn't too easy to try and figure out what to do. So what I've actually done is I've fished it out for a bit, and then I've made a couple of other really big balls with lots of bait in, and I've thrown them in. And it's really interesting where I've thrown them. I've actually thrown them quite a good way downstream. And the reason for that is the fish are definitely right on the bait. And when I started throwing those small balls to begin with, that's actually what it allowed me to figure out. It allowed me to figure out roughly where the fish were going to be in relation to my bait. So when I put 2 or 3 big balls in, I could try and put them in exactly the right place. Now, most of my bites have come as the float is sort of settling just down the peg, right onto the bait. So if I'd have put the balls in front of me, it would have been really difficult to actually fish there. But as it happens, because I've put the balls down the peg, I can lay the rig in slightly upstream, let it get in a nice position, and then run it onto the balls and catch a few fish. There's an odd smaller fish there like this, like odd bleak and things like that. But you can just catch them and enjoy doing it. It's not like you have to ship the pole in and out, because that's the beauty of having the whip there. But it's been really interesting. I think, to be honest, in the latter stages of the day, I could have started loose feeding, because the fish have definitely gone off and the fishing hasn't been as good as it was early on. Just a bit slower, maybe an odd bonus skimmer here or there, and we've developed a bit of a naughty downstream wind, which has made it a little bit awkward for the whip. But as you can tell, it's fishing all right, and I've kept them coming by changing it up, mixing it up, sometimes holding the float back. That's worked well as well. Little bleak there, took that one. Like holding the float back and just holding it over the bait best I can, and then sometimes running it downstream at the pace of the river. See, now when there's a little bit of a breeze on, it seems best just to check the float, let it set, and then just run through at the peg, almost at the pace of the river, because that's given me my best chance of not affecting my presentation. I've really enjoyed it. I've had to work hard. I've got probably a double figure net of fish there of all different sizes, and it's been beautiful, really good fishing. And that's what you get on rivers. And that's what this sort of whip can give you. It can give you the chance to work your peg. Sometimes I've had fish down here, sometimes I've had them upstream. And of course, being a whip, you're feeling everything. It's like bang, bang every time you hook a fish. So it's really exciting. Really, really enjoyed it. I've enjoyed a really nice fishing day fishing on the River Don today. Nice roach to finish here. And you can see I've caught all different size fish, all different species. It's been really, really good. And the best thing is I've only set up one 8 meter whip and one rig. It's a really, really underused tactic on waters like this and natural waters across Britain. Get out, give it a go. It really can catch you a lot of fish. Absolutely fantastic day.